Well, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Aaron Style. I'm assistant director here at the Gardens. And one of my great duties here at the Gardens is to manage our internship program. And we've had to change up the way we're delivering this content. We ask our interns every summer to present on their experiences for that summer. And with COVID and everything that's going on, we were unable to do this in person. So instead, we're going to do it virtually. And we have a short video from each of our interns this summer that talks about their experiences. All of our interns worked side by side with a staff person here at the Gardens. And throughout the summer, they attended special education sessions for them. And we did a few trips and did some hands-on activities, all sorts of things that help all of the interns learn better how a place like Reiman Gardens actually operates, and be able to see similar nonprofit organizations and how they run. And the goal here is to provide not only work experience relevant to their future career goals, but also educational opportunities to help expand their knowledge of places like Reiman Gardens. So you'll see here this afternoon in their videos all the different things that they were able to do and learn throughout the summer. I wanna give a big thank you before we get started. I wanna give a big thank you to some of those that contributed to help support the internship program every summer. This includes David Hoffman, the Story County Master Gardeners, and the Ames Garden Club. They have allowed us to do some of the really wonderful things that the interns will talk about here in just a little bit to contribute to their full experience here at the Gardens. So without further ado, we have videos for each of these interns and that they've pre-recorded. So we'll run those back to back. And then once all the videos are finished, we will open it up for questions and we'll have the interns answer those questions. So without further ado, let's get started with our first intern video.
Beautiful rhinestone has really great fragrance. It's not blooming at the moment, but it has a really good structure of a plant, and it's very disease resistant.
Ideas of what horticulture really was. I'd only taken one class at Iowa State about horticulture. And so I was really excited to get this knowledge under my belt. I've learned a lot more about propagation, plant species, and anything you can think of. My third biggest takeaway and what my leadership experience is going to lead into is digital engagement. Because of what we kind of got thrown into with COVID and the pandemic, we had to adjust our problems. When I first started, all of our problems engagement. So what that is we are taking on programs of that in person. Thank you. And the main thing that they do is collect produce from local farmers, clean it, store it, and then donate it to the local food pantries here in Story County. And so one aspect of helping with them this summer is that I have gone to the local farmers market here in Ames and collected produce because this year especially, they're having a difficult time finding volunteers who are willing to go out and about to collect the produce. So I've helped with that a couple of times, and all of the produce that they collect is stored here in this cooler behind me until it's ready to be distributed to the food pantries here in Story County. Another aspect that I've been working on is with some extra vegetable plants that we had here at Reiman Gardens and growing them out in a plot by the entrance to the gardens so that the produce can then be harvested and donated to Plant to Grow and then to the local food pantries. Because there are so many extra vegetable plants here at Reiman, I actually also did a small project with coordinating with volunteers here at Reiman Gardens so that they could pick up some of the extra plants we had and then grow them out in their own gardens and bring them back when they have the produce harvested. This was a really great way to engage volunteers because a lot of volunteers are also concerned about coming to the gardens to volunteer, and so this was just a really good opportunity to involve volunteers and also fill a need for a plant to grow.
My name is Kayron Robinson. I am an intern here at Reiman Gardens. My major is public horticulture at Iowa State University. I am a senior. This is actually my last semester, which is a really crazy last fall semester. I grew up in West Des Moines, Iowa, and I work in the greenhouse and production internship. So that's what we call the indoor horticulture. I primarily work in the conservatory, which is where we are right now. So this is not open this summer due to the pandemic, but we maintain it and weed it and water it and put on displays and all of that. And then we also work in the greenhouse, which I will show you, and also in the nurseries outdoor where we keep the trees. So three things that I've really learned a lot this summer has been I learned a lot about tropical plants, which I had not had any classes in. I want to learn a lot about, and being here obviously has really taught me a lot. So it working around this all the time, you learn a lot about the growth habits in the different IDs and just a lot about it. And now I have a lot in my apartment, a lot more than I should probably have in my apartment. Other things I've learned is that I've really been learning a lot about the different career options within horticulture. So that was primarily through our rotations, so working in the different departments within Reiman Gardens, and also on field trips, so all the different areas where you can work and all the different jobs you can have while still being in horticulture and how those interact with each other and work to accomplish great things through working together. And then what I would say I spent the most time on this summer has been watering. Working in nurseries and greenhouses, you spend many hours every day watering everything, keeping it alive and happy. And so I've learned a lot about recognizing symptoms if they're underwatered or overwatered, if there's pests or if there's any problems, being able to take note of that. So on our Wednesday sessions, something that I really liked that we had once was the education session, which really talked about our public events that we have here, as well as our different programs we offer. And what I really enjoyed about that conversation was that we really talked about how Reiman Gardens works to really attract people, to fill its goals in attracting people who don't necessarily know very much about horticulture. So bringing people in with diverse interests into Reiman Gardens and teaching them and educating them about horticulture, and how we accomplish that through public events and programs we offer that might attract people who are not horticulturists. So that was really interesting to me, and I was very excited to know how hard Reiman works to accomplish that. And so that was something I really liked. My leadership project has been doing flashcards for the conservatory, which has really helped me learn about tropical plants. So that means that I found images of all of the tropical plants in here. So I go around and I will find images of these plants and find the information, which thankfully a lot of the volunteers have found. I'll show you the greenhouses real quick in the nursery, which is also where I work. One moment and I will show you that. Okay, so these are the greenhouses. We have a lot of greenhouses, so we have all of these plants here still, primarily for some projects we're still working on and displays. We also take care of the nursery, which is where we're going to have our potted trees and all of our shrubs and all of that wonderfulness. I love watering out here because it's so beautiful. So yeah, so that's me and my internship. I hope you guys have a great rest of your summer and stay safe.
Welcome to Day in Life, where we go behind the scenes of Reiman Gardens summer interns. Would you be able to introduce yourself?
Yes, my name is Jesse Howard. I'm a junior in apparel merchandising here at Iowa State University. I'm from Adel, Iowa, and here at Reiman Gardens, I take the position of the retail management intern in the gift shop.
What are some things you learned this summer?
One of the things I learned this summer was a lot about visual merchandising. So what visual merchandising is, it's basically doing displays in a store with different merchandise. And I learned a lot about like different balance and symmetry throughout the store. So I'm really excited that I learned a lot about this because I've yet to take the visual merchandising class at Iowa State. I'll be taking it this upcoming fall. So I feel like I got my feet in the door already with that. Another thing I learned is how to talk to vendors. I've never done this before in my life, so it was really cool to get to experience that. So one thing I did was my supervisor and I went to market in Minneapolis back in June. And basically what market is basically a giant shopping center, and you find different merchandise you want to bring into your store. So there I discussed with different vendors, different merchandise you might be interested in. And also throughout the summer, I took different phone calls with different people and discussed different buying plans and what else to get for the store. Another thing I learned was how to bring up my own buying plan. So I had a little bit of background in this through classes I took at Iowa State previously. But through this, I learned different budget and how to do different budget cuts and what type of merchandise I should bring to the store. One thing my supervisor taught me is that when you're buying, you should get something that's 8% something that you like, and then 20% is something that you would totally never buy. So you have different balance for every single type of audience.
What is the highlight of one of your professional development days?
So during the internship time, my favorite day was probably when we made floral arrangements. That's definitely the thing that's most up my alley that I've been most interested in, because I have a roommate who's actually event management, and she would come home this past semester and bring home all her huge floral arrangements. I thought it was super cool. So it was really fun to get to learn how to do that, and I really enjoyed going out into the garden and being able to cut whatever I wanted. It felt so freeing to be able to choose any type of flower or plant that I wanted to make the floral arrangement. So that was definitely something I was most proud of.
What was your leadership experience this summer?
So for my project for my internship, I came up with my own buying plan, and I decided to bring a whole line of merchandise that focused on bees. So I'll show you a few things that I chose. So first thing I did is I chose some different t-shirt styles. This is the women's, and we also have in sizes youth and in toddler style. I brought in some mugs, some bee mugs, as you can see right here. And then probably the thing I'm most proud of is I brought in local honey. So Jamie Byer is a guy, he lives in Story County, and then he harvests bees, or honey from bees. And so I brought in different types of honey jars, and I'm really proud of that because we've never had anything like that in the gift shop before. If you move on, you can see I brought in some different types of honey jars to put your honey in. There's more merchandise down over here. If you want to look in this corner, I have some tea dispensers here and salt and pepper shakers over there. Here are some to-go mugs. And just a few more merchandise. And I also did this entire display. And I made these posters as well, just to enhance my display. So for my buy-in project, it took a lot more work than it looks than just bringing in merchandise. I had to research through a ton of different magazines and find different vendors and find what would work for the store or not. There was a few trips along the way. I ordered some merchandise and it ended up they were out of stock, so that was always a little bit disappointing because it was something that I really wanted to bring into the store. I also had to figure out what the right budget was with my supervisor, make sure I wasn't going over budget. For the honey, we had to research between different local honey because I really wanted to bring local honey into the store because that's a really big selling point for the audience that comes to Reiman Gardens. He's asking a question.
Oh.
This is going to take longer than you think because I cannot talk. Okay, redo. Hi, everyone. I'm Alexis Acton. I'm one of the outdoor horticulture garden and landscape maintenance interns for this summer at Reiman Gardens. I am a biology and horticulture major at Iowa State, and I will be going into my senior year this year. I am from Lincoln, Nebraska originally, and I started working at Reiman Gardens in early March, so right before the pandemic hit, so I've seen it all. But it's been a really fun summer. A few things that I learned this summer were how to design landscapes. So here at Reiman Gardens, we are constantly changing out annuals, perennials, shrubs, and trees. So I got to be able to help with that a lot this summer and early this spring especially. It was really interesting to just watch and learn from the head horticulturalists how they design the landscapes here, and even take that and apply that to how I was able to design the containers in my section of the garden. I am in charge of maintaining the whole northeast side of the gardens this year, and so that includes the Campanile Garden, the Trials, the Herb Garden, the Rose Garden, and the Bald Cypress Alley, and the Hardwood Forest. So it's been a lot of fun, and I've got to use a lot of colors, textures, shapes, and varieties of plants to design different spaces. Another thing that I've learned this summer is how to educate people on Reiman Gardens' mission. So we're all about educating and enchanting and inspiring people about plants, butterflies, and the natural world. So it's been really fun to just have a lot of people come up to me during the day and just ask me questions about what plant is this, how do you best care for it, how do you grow it. And yeah, it's just been a lot of fun, and I've gotten to help with some educational sessions, which has been a lot of fun. Another thing that I've learned this summer is, this kind of goes into my leadership project. So my leadership project, I was in charge of designing three new trial beds for 2020. So these trial beds each contain 10 new cultivars of roses. And so I was tasked with designing the space for the beds, preparing the site, which included taking out the sod and tilling the ground, taking some soil samples, planting the roses, mulching, fencing, and then now
just watering and upkeep, general upkeep of the beds. So they are all growing really well right now. And what I've learned through that is part of my responsibility is taking evaluations every month. So every day I go and check on them and take some pictures. And then once a month I am able to take evaluations on these roses for plant breeders and geneticists. And what they will do with this information over 2 years is determine whether they want to keep these cultivars, these new species, or not, and put them on the market. And so I have learned how to evaluate their color, their texture, how they grow, if they're disease resistant, if they have any damage on them, like pest damage. And so, yeah, that's been really neat. One of my highlights from this summer has been learning all about the design process of different botanical gardens, including Reiman Gardens and the Greater Des Moines Botanical Gardens. So we met up with Sarah Remery this summer for one of our workshops, and we got to learn all about the 2020 master plan here at Reiman Gardens, as well as when we went down to the Greater Des Moines Botanical Gardens, we got to learn about their master plan and how it was their outdoor space. It's a much younger space than Reiman Gardens is, so they only have a very small fraction of their space done, whereas at Reiman Gardens we have pretty much, you know, utilized all of our outdoor space and are just changing it to make it more appealing to guests. Yeah, so that has been my internship experience this summer, and yeah.
Hi, my name is Kate Holmes. I am from Moline, Illinois. I am one of the outdoor horticulture interns, and I am majoring in horticulture with an emphasis in landscape design at Iowa State. So working at Reiman has been a really great experience that has given me a lot of different opportunities this summer. And I never knew how a public garden operated beforehand, so it was really neat to see all the different departments within Reiman Gardens. All right, so working at Reiman Gardens or any other horticulture facility gives you the opportunity to learn about different plants that you either haven't known beforehand or just had only seen in pictures. So like one example is I had always known of Baptisia and Ansonia. I'd seen them in pictures, I'd learned them in class, but I never really got familiar with them until I worked here by just digging them out and actually experiencing them. So another thing I learned while working here at Reiman is being able to see how a public garden operates. I had visited Reiman many times beforehand, along with other botanical centers, and I had always wondered how they take care of such large spaces. So actually working at one and seeing all the hard work that is put into it makes me appreciate public gardens a whole lot more. And being a landscape design major, I also have grown a deeper appreciation for these public gardens. And could even see myself working in a public garden someday in the future.
The original thing that I learned while working here this summer was learning about the prairie and a little bit of history about it, and as well as kind of how a prairie operates and how they're extremely important to Iowa. And that kind of ties along with my current project, which is doing a restoration of Prairie Vista, or a proposal for restoration. Okay, so I proposed for restoration of Prairie Vista because I wanted to reflect what the Iowa prairie was like. So the Iowa prairie was known as the tall grass prairie, yet there are no tall grasses in here at all. And when I was looking at the original plant list, I saw that they did have big blue stem, little blue stem, switchgrass, and all those native plants that you would see in an Iowa prairie. However, I think due to lack of maintenance, those plants were overgrown, and now it's overtaken by solidago, as you can see. In order to prevent that, we need a better maintenance plan, which is what I have come up with.
Throughout my time at working at Reiman, from January up until now, I have not visited another botanical center. So when we visited the Greater Des Moines one, it was really cool to see it with a fresh set of eyes, just because I now know how, like, all the hard work that is put into working at these types of gardens and all the thought that is put into it.
one thing that was really interesting was seeing that both Reiman and the Des Moines Garden, you can tell that there are different things that are prioritized at each one, and there are a lot of similarities and differences between the two. Working at Reiman Gardens has been a really great experience that I'm grateful to have had, and it has really widened my perspective on possible careers I could have in the future, whether it be landscape design or public horticulture. It was a great experience overall.
Hello, my name is Delana Rogers. I'm a senior in Global Resource Systems and Horticulture, and I am from outside of Linden, Iowa. My intern title is Glasshouse Display and Greenhouse Production Intern. The first thing we do at 6:30 is water. So this is warm zone. Entomology zone. Just standing by themselves. These are all sycamore falls. Have a hoop house. And then we have the nursery and again some trees right outside of it. So the conservatory is the last place we are responsible for watering. The beds go all the way around. You have your center bed here, and then you also have the upper area and the back there that we call the hill. Something that I learned during this internship is just how to be more adaptable and flexible to unplanned for situations that occur in the professional world. I mean, the pandemic changed a lot of how Reiman Gardens operates and interacts with its visitors. So just kind of experiencing and witnessing firsthand all the problem solving and the brainstorming of creative solutions so that Reiman Gardens can still be open to the public, but also keep its visitors and staff safe. Another thing that I learned during this internship is more about all the various departments that make up Reiman Gardens and how each contributes to making Reiman Gardens the successful horticulture institution that it is. You know, public gardens are a lot more than just plants. You have to have someone to manage volunteers. You have to have a team that comes up with educational programs. You have to have a team that is able to market the garden and to bring new visitors in. There's a lot that comes into making a business successful, and kind of through this internship, learning about those departments was really integral in experiencing my own knowledge of how a nonprofit functions. Through this internship, I also was able to increase upon my own experience and professional communication skills. All the interns themselves were kind of on a team. We had to make sure that we were able to collaborate and produce those weekly blog posts. We had to make sure that each of these presentations were different in nature and that we weren't discussing too many of the similar things. So it's always good to be a part of different teams and to just improve upon those communication skills with other people. My favorite part about the weekly educational sessions was actually the plant walks. During the plant walks, we would visit a part of the garden with the specific Reiman Garden horticulture professional staff member who kind of manages it. These plant walks were super important to me because being an indoor horticulture intern, you know, I wasn't exposed as much to the outdoor displays and didn't have a lot of knowledge about what plants were out there. It's always good as a horticulture major, you know, to expand upon your knowledge base and your technical skill set with ornamental plants as well as native plants.
For my leadership project, I created cello systems with Denny for tomatoes, pumpkins, kale, and mums, all made from repurposed materials. For the tomatoes, I used round cages and a hanging system made from PVC pipe, twine, and bread ties to find a less labor-intensive system than Florida weaving. An A-frame trellis was made for the pumpkins with scrap wood and leftover snow fence and construction fence. Slings from old t-shirts, produce bags, etc. will be made to help support the developing pumpkins. For an upcoming show, we want to grow kale and mums with straight stems. This trellis system is made from PVC pipe and trellis netting that holds the plants within a grid system to force the stems to grow vertically.
My name is Isabel Armstrong. I am a senior in event management, and I'm originally from Cedar Falls, Iowa. I am the private events intern here at Reiman Gardens, and today we have a wedding of about 160 people, so you're going to follow me today as we go through what I do when there's a big event happening. So right now, it's about an hour out from the wedding ceremony, so we go through and we set up all the wedding chairs, and we go through and sanitize them, so we're good to go when the guests arrive. Right now, we're in Bald Cypress Alley. It's a very popular wedding spot here.
The ceremony is just about to start. So as you can see, everything is pretty much set up, good to go. The caterers are starting to arrive. The bar is starting to arrive. So I kind of walk around and greet everybody, but I thought I'd take this opportunity to share three things that I learned this summer. So the first one was make sure that you have good relationships with other people in other departments. You never know when you're gonna need them. For example, I utilized Kate, one of the horticulture interns, because we had a situation down by the lake where a hawk was disturbing a wedding, so I had to call her to figure out what I could do to figure it out. Another example of what you need to know is make sure everyone is on the same page in terms of timelines, setup, everything like that. So two EAs here, Shayla and Tessa, they did all the setup for this in terms of tables and chairs. All the vendors knew what time to be here, where, what door to come into. You can go outside and come take a look at some of the setup that Tessa and Shayla did. And then finally, the most important thing I learned is wear comfortable shoes, because I learned that the hard way. You do a lot of walking here and you just have to constantly be flexible. Vendors want the bars moved, clients want things different places. Like for example, they wanted another head table outside today. That was not the original plan, so it was an easy thing. We could be flexible. And
so the wedding is starting, so one thing I do is I kind of hide in the bushes and make sure that the public is being respectful so that they don't walk into the wedding and that everyone stays quiet so they can have that really special moment walking down the aisle.
I want to take a minute to talk about my leadership experience. So rarely do interns get the chance to see a wedding from start to finish. I actually had that opportunity. So I had a bride and her mother, the bride's name was Tiana, come to us about late May, early June. They were originally supposed to get married in Jamaica, but because of COVID-19, their wedding had to be canceled. So they were still looking to get married at the end of July, and they saw our venue, never been to Reiman Gardens before, and absolutely fell in love with it. So I was able to work with the mother of the bride and the bride to plan this wedding in a month and a half. The bride fell in love with the archways here. It looked almost identical to their venue in Jamaica. They had macrame curtains and they decorated it real pretty. I personally have never seen a bride ever get married under here, and we had to fit a large number of people under here, so it was a unique challenge to get it done. That was really exciting. And then they went on to have an open house type reception out at Huntsaker. It is currently 9:51 p.m. and the party and the dancing is well underway. You can probably hear it in the background. All the guests and everyone is out on the events plaza. The couple has done their first dance, cut their cake. Everyone's eaten dinner. We got all the chairs cleaned up in Bald Cypress Alley. And now it's just party time. Everyone gets to enjoy the wedding. I wanted to take a minute before I sign off for the night to highlight some of my favorite parts of the weekly education sessions that we do here for the interns.
intern program at Reiman Gardens, I absolutely loved getting to hear from all the different professionals in their areas of the gardens, because it really helped me understand what it takes to have this garden run as a whole. And I also just loved learning about the history of Reiman Gardens. I found it very interesting. And I also went on to share that knowledge with rental clients to help them fully experience Reiman Gardens when they rent a space from us. So myself and an event monitor will hang out here at the front desk, so we're easily visible but not in the way of the event in case anything happens. But other than that, once the party ends at 11, they have a short time period to get everything out, any decorations they brought, their dresses, their suit jackets, everything like that. And then myself and the event monitor will lock everything up, secure the building, and then head out for the night. And the wedding is
all right. It is 11:30 at night and we are calling it quits. I hope you enjoyed following along with me today as the private events intern at Reiman Gardens. Bye.
Take it away, Aaron.
There, now I'm not muted anymore. As you can see, the interns have had a lot of really wonderful experiences this summer. You probably noticed that each of them were paired up with a staff person that they worked very closely with all summer long, and then had opportunities to do educational programs and sessions throughout the summer, as well as a couple local field trips. We had to make a lot of adjustments to our program this summer because of COVID. And I want to thank the interns for being so flexible and accommodating throughout our whole summer. I hope they still were able, and it looks like they were able, to still get a lot out of this experience. So thanks to them, and thanks to all the staff at Reiman Gardens who spend time with these students and really help them find some of their real loves and career passions for the future. At this time, we have an opportunity to answer any questions that you may have from the interns. If there's somebody specific or not, we'll have them come and sit here. They are spread out in this big room here waiting for us to ask any questions, and then kind of come over and sit down. So you can either send a question using the chat function or turn your speaker or your microphone on and just ask it.
I'll ask a question, Aaron.
Yes.
Hey, so I just put in the chat there, I'd love to hear more about how the wedding worked under the Rose Garden Arbor. You know, maybe there are ways to like improve the space to like make it more enticing or a popular space, because I too had never thought of that as the actual ceremony spot in that garden. You know, we've had in other places. So I'm curious like how that worked and, you know, what else can we do there?
Yeah. And Izzy is the one intern that wasn't able to make it here today. So she unfortunately answered the question. But I think that is something, you know, I think that illustrates too just how helpful the interns can be to us here at Reiman Gardens. That is definitely a question we'll ask, because I know that she will continue to work with the gardens through the fall semester to help us do some of the programming that we're doing. So we value, as staff, as you can see, really value kind of the input from the students as well. So thanks for the question, Sarah, even though I can't answer it.
I have a question for Annika. I know that one of the major things that she's done this summer is work on observational evaluations to watch people and evaluate how people are responding to the protocols we've set in place from COVID. So I just want to hear a little bit more from her.
Yeah, so all summer, you kind of put me in charge of the observations. And so it was a lot of communication through the education staff, and then the rest of the staff here at Reiman. A lot went into it, and many, many, many hours went into graphing and Excel sheets. And we're very thankful for the other staff who has helped with our observations, because it can be a lot, and we had to modify it from beginning to where we are now. Thank you to the staff.
All right, what other questions do folks have? Does it? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm trying. That's all the lower it goes.
No, go up.
Technology is so fun.
Oh, there we go. We're looking at the chat to make sure we didn't miss any questions here. Well, there was one comment, and Kate, if you wouldn't mind talking a little bit about irrigation. We love irrigation here at Reiman Gardens. So I'm gonna give Kate an opportunity here to come over.
Yay, Kate, talk about your irrigation problems.
Hello. Yeah, so going into working here, I didn't really know anything about irrigation. I mean, I knew like what it did, but I really didn't know how to fix it or anything like that. And so coming here, irrigation breaks a lot. So it was a really good opportunity to learn like how to fix broken irrigation heads or just irrigation lines. So yeah, I'm glad I got to learn a little bit about it. So that's all I got for that. What? The very top.
Okay, so it says, why should you plant a Kentucky coffee tree? It is easy to grow, and there's some really cool cultivars. There's a small short one that is really nice. And what else? There's really interesting plants. Let's see.
Looks like there's two messages.
Hey, Chase.
Yes.
I would add it's probably the hardest tree to ever sell in a nursery, because when it's a young tree, it looks like a stick. From past experience working in a nursery, it's hard to sell a Kentucky coffee tree because people cannot envision what a beautiful tree it turns into.
They're all comments. There's no questions, guys.
I don't think there are any other questions.
Okay. We can save the chat and you guys can look at them.
Everybody did a wonderful job. Those videos were great.
They were great. And I just want to reiterate, I appreciate the flexibility that the interns had this summer. These videos, I asked them to make a week and a half before they were due to me. Typically, this presentation is done in person, and we had worked all summer under that assumption, and then it became very clear that wasn't going to be a possibility. And they pivoted and did a really wonderful job on each one of the videos. So I hope you enjoyed this as much as the rest of us did. I do know that this was recorded, and so you can tell folks that there'll be a recording of it available on the Reiman Gardens website very soon. So thank you very much for all those who attended and all those who are watching this. I hope you learned a lot about what all of our interns learned about this summer.